Helps you keep warm.
She is the future.
future and the past, mother of all, of earth and sky, she carries me to the other side. She carries me, she carries me.
Then little sister spoke, saying, "We would ask now of death." And grandmother said, "You would know the secret of death? But how shall you find it, unless you seek it in the heart of life? The owl, whose night-bound eyes are blind unto the day, cannot unveil the mystery of light. If you would indeed behold the spirit of death, open your heart wide unto the body of life. For life and death are one, even as the river and the sea are one. In the depth of your hopes and desires lies your silent knowledge of the beyond, and like seeds dreaming beneath the snow, your heart dreams of spring. Trust the dreams, for in them is hidden the gate to eternity. Your fear of death is but the trembling of the shepherdess when she stands before her queen, whose hand is to be laid in sisterhood and honoring upon that very shepherdess. Is the shepherdess not joyful beneath her trembling that she remembers finally that she too is sovereign? For what is it to die but to stand naked in the wind, one with all, and to melt into the sun? And what is it to cease breathing but to free that breath from its restless tides, that it may rise and expand and return to the breast of goddess, now light and free and unencumbered? Only when you drink from the river of silence shall you indeed sing. And when you have reached the mountain top, then you shall begin to sail to the stars. And when Mother Earth shall reclaim your limbs with love, then shall you be free to truly dance with all life."
So here we are coming together in the celebration of the spirit of that wonderful being who we have known as friend and daughter and mother and sister to so much. Kindly one, in my experience, one of wit and wisdom, our sister, Cathy Probst. So we will share poetry and music to honor Cathy, and we shall hear from those who asked in advance to speak, and maybe a couple more, time permitting. So we have lit a candle for Cathy to help light her way. Not that she isn't already surrounded by everything, light, dark, liminal, and everything between and beyond. But it is our symbolic gesture to light a candle to give her additional light and love as she makes her way into her next experience. So ancestresses, we humbly ask for your blessing upon this ceremony. Help us to be good caretakers of this land, the land upon which Cathy walked in her life. North and south, east and west, air, fire, water, and earth, we acknowledge you with deep reverence. And Great Mother, of course, you, we, are at the center of everything that is, including this loving ceremony dedicated to your daughter, Cathy. I have been deeply moved by Cathy's crossing, a lot more so than I thought I would be. I didn't hang out with Cathy. I knew her only by her coming for many years to Goddess Temple Circle events. There was something about Cathy that was so kind and witty and brave. I could see that she was probably in some considerable discomfort when she would come in with her walker. But she always gave me that big smile. And I don't know what other people's experience is, but I never heard her complain once to me or even ask for anything special. She was just, her radiance, her presence was unusual to me, and I was very drawn to her. So we will miss her a great deal. And of course, you know, we always say, you know, nothing is lost and everything continues and there's no death and all of that. But there is something about the physical body that we humans come to love and rely on. And when that moves on and that body is no longer in our physical presence in this dense reality, there can be pain. Even for the most spiritually advanced person, there can be a sense of loss. And I have felt that since Cathy's crossing. So, blessed be. Is Paul Wirin on? Paul, have you joined us today?
Yes.
Oh, Paul, okay. Can we, oh, very good. Oh, I'm so glad. We had a bit of trouble with our emails and I repeatedly emailed you and it looked like it was bouncing back. So I'm just so glad that you are here and that it all somehow worked out beautifully.
I'm glad to be here. I'm very, very grateful to be in the august presence of all these wonderful goddesses, appreciators of the great reality. And I feel very comforted in your company. So I'm so grateful to be here. Just want to say a couple of things. That Cathy was at once certainly one of the smartest women I've ever met, one of the most spiritual women I've ever met. And there were a couple of things we like to do every year in this nature of appreciating the goddess and everything. And I used to tell her frequently that I enjoyed her company because usually my appreciation rises to such an extreme in these occasions that I only talk to fanatics so I don't seem insane. But the joy of her company was that she understood. But it wasn't a fanaticism, it was a real in-depth realization of the great reality. She was a very self-effacing person. She didn't wear her spiritual depth on the outside. One would get to know her and see the consistency that ran through her life and the strength that ran through her life. And in the end, it was her very realization itself in this avalanche of bad news, maybe unable to change a story, to shift in relation to it, and show us all how this is done. We're very grateful for her wonderful example of a life well lived, even all the way to the end. And the other reason why I'm grateful for your company today is because, of course, after this meeting, I'm going to want to call her, see how she's doing. But I have you guys, so thank you so very much.
Should be. Leslie. Close, good friend, Leslie. Leslie, are you with us today?
Very saddening to get Marcia's text and to hear of Kathy's passing. I'd been to visit her when she could get a visitor, and then all that's going on in the world happened, and she was not allowed visitors, but we did touch base through text and different things. And shortly before she passed, we were corresponding, and she was very upbeat, and she sounded very wonderful and positive. So I was quite shocked to hear of her passing. I've known Cathy for more than 25 years. I met her as a birthday gift. My brother arranged for me to go with Cathy and Marcia to see Amma as my birthday gift one year, and we became fast friends. Attended many different things together, as well as the Goddess Temple, Circle of Aradia, campouts, events with Amma, just getting together to eat and talk. I will miss her greatly. I don't know, and when someone that you're close to goes, it leaves such a space that I wonder what will come in to help fill that space. And I hope it's something as wonderful as Cathy was. I catch myself thinking of her often, and I see something on Facebook, I think, oh, I should send that to Cathy. And I will miss her. I will miss her a lot. Even when she was in pain, even when she had her own problems, she was always a wonderful friend and a beautiful, peaceful person to be around. Knowing her brought me great joy.
Blessed be.
Rita?
Oh, there you are.
Cathy, she was a great example of a true bhakta. A bhakta lives their life in love. Love of God, love of Goddess, and love of humanity. The bhakta sees everything through the perception of love. Their main desire is to love, and even to love the things you hate, you know, to some degree, to just embrace life through love. And Cathy is a great example of living her life from the space of love. She was so devoted to Amma. And she was devoted to her friends. She was devoted to her cats. She was devoted to living a life of joy and love, because a part of love is also joy. And even in some of her most trying times, she always seemed to find a way to bring a smile to her face and to the faces of those around her. Well, her great friend Marcia Lang and Cathy, I to myself refer to them as the wandering sadhu sisters, because Cathy and Marcia, they've been quite the travelers, and they used to get in their old car and, you know, they'd come from West Covina to the Goddess Temple, and they'd go down to San Diego, and they'd go up to San Ramon where Alma was. I mean, these two women, if you want to know what it's like to be a modern day wandering sadhu, well, you just look to them. And I'm sure that Kathy's still going to be sitting in that car next to Marcia, maybe even driving it sometimes. And so I just miss her loving, joyous, precious heart. And I don't know if you can see this, I made a little altar for her. And it's got like Mother Mary, she was such a devotee of goddess. Lakshmi, this is Saraswati, the goddess of wisdom. Because Kathy was very wise, like Paul pointed out. She was a great intellect, but she was very humble about it. Mother Mary, and of course, I have a chocolate bar here because Kathy was an admitted foodie. She loved food. She enjoyed fine food and food of all kinds. So I have a little chocolate bar for her. And she was so gracious. When my mother died in 2012, Kathy and Marcia came to see me, and they also attended the rosary for my mother. And it's like they fit in with all these other people that they didn't know, just like they had been, you know, friends with me and my family and all these other people all of their lives. So I missed her. I miss her very much. I was just making plans to go visit her again. I had visited her along with Marcia Works and Marcia Lang just about a couple months ago before all this stuff happened. And I had been talking to her. I talked to her about a week before she left. She was starting a new program for her health conditions. And, you know, not a hint of there being anything untoward.
Right.
So it did, like Leslie said, it came as a great shock when I got an email and a text about 1 o'clock in the morning one night. And I'm going like, that must be Marcia Lang. I don't know.
Yeah.
That's what.
Thank you so much.
Bye, Ma. Sorry, Ma.
Thank you.
I love you, Kathy, wherever you are.
Mata, Naiad Priestess of the Goddess Temple, now joins us to share her perspective on behalf of the temple. Welcome, Mata.
Thank you. I was always pleased to see Kathy when she came to temple or any party. She was always there. Kathy loved, to me, what I felt is that she loved to party. She loved to have fun. She loved to gather together with all of her brothers and sisters and friends and family. And you know, that's really it, is if she cast her attention upon you, you were her family. And that was very, very powerful and so delightful of her. And when I heard of the news, I just felt, I looked for her where she is, not where she was. And I felt such joy, and everything turned pink, and I knew she was here. And I know that she is here now, and that she is enjoying this expression of love right now. And I will look for her where she is, and I can share my stories or my interests with her right now. And there is no, I don't need to call her up now. I don't need to text her. I don't need to, well, not text, email her. Well, sometimes text, but I can just bake with her. And she is fulfilled in all of us, in all of our words, in all of our thoughts, in all of our hearts. Blessed be.
Blessed be. Blessed be. Thank you so much, Mata. There she is. Oh, very good. Kara Dwin, thank you, first of all, for all the wonderful work you do in leading Circle of Aradia, a huge job, and you do it with such grace and beauty. We are deeply, deeply appreciative for you joining us here today. Thank you.
It's an honor to be here, Ava, and I want to thank you for hosting this really special, special gathering. And I'm glad I'm not the only one that's technologically mind-boggled. You're not alone. I really would like to hold hands virtually with everybody. That's what I'm used to in Circle. And thank goddess we do have this evil beast of a machine to use. To connect with each other when we can't be together in person. So blessed be for this. And I want to reach out to Marsha Lang. I'm sending you a great big cyber hug, Marsha. Kathy's a longtime friend, companion, and housemate, and they're like Mutt and Jeff or Thelma and Louise. So I'm not sure which is which. But a huge hug to Marsha. And so I have some things that I want to say about Cathy, who was a very loving woman. She loved people and was very social and always had a warm, genuine smile and hug for all the women in our community when we met. I saw her in Circle of Radia and Sandy Cabelli's Moon Circles and other places. She loved to talk. And about so many interesting subjects. I love that she was once a classical musician, as I'm a lover of classical music. And I could have talked hours with her about that. And she probably would have too, if time permitted. She was very wise and intelligent, as people have always said. And there was also a mischievous side to her, I think. She was like a maidenish crone. There was this twinkle in her eye when she was telling an amusing story. So she's maiden and crone. But we also shared a love of a particular comic strip. So does Marsha. It's called Get Fuzzy. I don't know if any of you, I mean, you could probably do a thumbs up if you want to, if you're familiar with Get Fuzzy. So I like to clip comics for my friends. You know, it's good to have humor in life. And Cathy certainly had a good sense of humor. So this is Get Fuzzy, if you could see it. I don't know if you could see that.
Sort of a little bit.
it's a comic strip about cats and dogs. So it's a dog satchel and a cat bucky, and they're always bagging on each other. And I like the comic strip so much that I actually had one on my refrigerator, my favorite one, which I just want to share. You see the little parts of it. Basically, Bucky the cat is a Siamese, very snarky cat, is reading an article in a magazine called Mad Cat. I don't know if Marsha's already read this one. And the dog's saying, so what are you interested in there? And the cat goes, he was the world's most feared cat burglar. And Satchel the dog goes, ha, why would anyone in their right mind want to steal more cats? He'd be scarier if he'd broken in and left cats. If he broke in here, it'd be all like, cats in the kitchen, Art, burgle up. Just be sure you don't drop any other cats on your way out, dude. Or Was he providing a service like vacuuming up excess cats? So the cat goes, enjoy your time on the cat hit list, pal. And Satchel's closing line is, hard not to with all the yarn and laser pointers that will be keeping me company. I wanted to share that one for y'all and for Cathy. So she was humorous and loving, and she could also get up on her soapbox and call out unfairness or injustices when she felt like it was in the mood, whether on a personal or global level. I'm glad she was never mad at me. You wouldn't have wanted to be the one to get into Cathy's way. I pray that Cathy is delighting all in the Summerland, sharing stories, bringing the spirit of laughter, and may she send some of that to us, and playing in the orchestra of the ancestors. And I want to close with a short poem by Carolyn Hillier to Cathy, and it's called A Good Lament. May you gently flow like a river. May your song be freed upon the wind. May you laugh again by the ocean and dance once more across the moonlit sand. We will find you by the gentle river. We will feel your song upon the wind. We will hear your laughter by the ocean and dance with you across the moonlit sand. Blessed be.
Blessed be. Caradwyn, thank you. Close, close friend, Melissa, priestess of the Goddess Temple and other temples, Sandy Limina.
I'm not real good at speaking off the cuff at this point. I wrote a poem for Cathy when I heard the news, and it's gone through a few revisions. So I wanted to read the poem and close with some words from Jeannie Coates, who used to come to Moon Circles and was a friend of Cathy's as well. She's involved with her UU church and can't come today, but she wanted to send her regrets. Cathy, we knew you would go, but not so soon, we didn't think. You were in such pain, but complaining wasn't you. We knew you were going, just not so fast. You were always there for us when we lost someone. And now you're gone too. Every time you put us off asking about how we were or everyone else's news, taking our minds off you, reaching out from your pain to help others with theirs, you were good at that. So many memories of you, full moons, pujas, classes, trips, sekhmet, goddess temples. You never did your homework, much to Marcia's dismay, but it didn't seem to faze you. You learned anyway, always the seeker. Forever Amma's devotee, Catholic or otherwise, you always found your way to Ma. Full moons, you nodding off, holding the peace candle. Marcia's whispering, wake up, Probst. So many memories of you. Dozing in your special chair, Kamala perched by you, at the computer, finding some silly YouTube video. I remember trips to Simon. Acupuncture took all day. We had to have lunch. I'd sit impatient, bemused, knowing you hurt, but you enjoying food out. How could I not take the day? Until work got in the way and the drive too long, and we couldn't anymore. Now I remember those shining days. I will miss your talks and your caring ways. Almost your last text was to ask for a candle for Marcia. Oh, Probst, you are so missed. We know you're waiting for us to cross, so you can hug us again in your warm, open arms. We will see you in the Summerlands, dear friend. as we dance together once more on new legs. And Jeannie reminded me of something her mother said. As survivors, the ones that are left here, is to realize that the others still here are even more precious.
Thank you, Sandy. Thank you. Brother Anthony, would you care to share? No pressure.
Well, strangely, being your brother, you would think I could add. It is difficult to. Yes, I feel the same that every time I come home or something, I think, oh, this is the time to call Cathy. When a relative or friend has shared memories, I think, I want to. Oh, of course, it's with Cathy. family and long old record, right? Because we also lost a longtime family friend in her 90s, just 10 days before Cathy, and she had been attentive to that. And at one point, even Marcia had a bit of dizziness due to anemia, and Cathy was on that. From her bed, she called 911 for Marcia. Yeah, one last big help. Yes. So, it's hard to summarize. I'm her brother. I know her all my life. I've lost, a second sister because her younger sister and my other older sister, the middle child, died 4 years ago. So her loss is quite heavy. Yes. I thought she would last another 10 years. Well, we'd get old together. But and, so many things, too, as I say, attendee of your temple, prodigal Catholic 15 years ago, Star Trek fan, science fiction fan. She knew so many people through all these things, people I've never met and some I have, such as Paul. As some of the people who've texted me back have said, when I obtained Kathy's phone, I was able to text some people and tell them. They said, well, she'll leave a bigger hole than you imagine in people's lives, more lives than you imagine. That's what some of them said. Yes. And, as I say, it's still quite hard to absorb. And this lockdown business hasn't helped either. I was at least allowed to visit with her a half hour the day before she died. That was something. And she gave out with a love litany. Now, it was difficult to understand her speech because she was in this BiPAP mask. And it's difficult also to talk when your entire priority is breathing. We don't realize the extent to which that's true. This is like trying to talk with her mouth open. But she, she first said, you and Marcia, you're my greatest friends. And then she went on to some relatives, friends. I made out distinct names at some point, but it was such a long litany that many of you are probably named in that list, that litany. I remember, some friends that live far away, some of our cousins, but as I say, more and more and more names. So it's entirely possible, I'm sure she must have mentioned Sandy Limina, she must have mentioned Leslie Phipps. And in fact, I think I did hear Leslie Phipps. Now, my memory is not good, but it's, and that's all really I can say at this point. I'm sorry.
Thank you, Tony. Thank you.
And I guess I should also add, yes, again, my confidant, my last confidant, really, that knew me when and so forth, Yes. She would say, call me any time of the day or night. Of course, I would wait till a civilized time, of course.
Tony, our hearts are with you.
Thank you.
We are all together in this. She is so special to us all. Our hearts are with you. Blessed be.
Thank you.
Oh, Marcia, there you are, sister.
Well, everything everybody said is so much so, because I remembered Sarah saying Thelma, referring to us as Thelma Louise, and that was something that our then roommate Dante used to call every time we'd go somewhere. Also, we were referred to as pilgrims and also as God junkies by some of our friends at the Kali Mandir. It was, for myself, I'm still in shock. Tony and I keep on saying, I can't believe she's gone when we talk on the phone and we do stuff, you know, and I'm trying to help through all this stuff you have to do when people pass and junk like that. And basically, I met Cathy in 1985, 86, I'm not quite sure, through science fiction fandom. We were good friends from that time on. We had our go to conventions, do all this other stuff. And then in 1990, we had our Sunday that we would all get together, eat food, watch videos. Cathy says, well, I have to leave at some point because, you know, friend of hers had invited her to see Amma, given her a flyer. And I said, well, that sounds very interesting. I'd like to go with you. And we said, well, we're going to come back and all this other stuff and pick our friends up. And that was, I could say, one of those life-changing times, because we went down and saw Amma at the Cottontail Ranch, which was in Malibu Canyon. And that's where they had had their whole, you know, weekend retreat and stuff like that. And Cathy always used to tell me, she goes, yes, you know, and she would have her experiences of Amma and stuff like that. And they were always tinged with humor. And that first day when we saw her, we were in there when the bathhouse washing up and stuff like that. And somebody said, oh, Amma's coming and stuff like that. Okay. We go out, we look, and Cathy's looking at her and I'm watching her. She walks by. And Cathy says, at that moment, she says, I think to myself, so this is a holy person. And Amma's down there about 25 feet away, turns around, looks at her, and laughs. And then turns back and continues walking down to the Darshan Hall, as we called it. And Cathy's like, looks around, looks behind her, and she goes, I'm the only person there. My mind's been read. You know? And she just, like I say, she always, you know, mother, my Amma was like, she was so enraptured by her. She went to go see her in Santa Fe, which was another back and forth with mother, was still on that same trip in the U.S. And she said, you know, so here I am standing in the back of the bubble tent, and I'm wondering, those people over there are getting a second hug. Why are they getting a second hug? She trots up and asks a question as usual. And she says, oh, okay. So mantra? Okay, sure, you know, and stuff like that. And she said, I was so besotted with mother that I simply got my mantra from her simply because I wanted a second hug. And I go, I guess I'm a devotee now. You know, so, you know, like I say, she always said all of her interactions, and even though our interactions were not verbal with mother, but she would periodically just say a little English every once in a while to people, were always, always humorous. And for myself, she was a great companion. She was someone I could talk to about anything, which also reminded me very much of my own mortal father. She was there, always there. And like I say, you know, just brought a lot of joy to everybody, to everybody and everything. Very spiritual, very, 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 you know, giving, kind. And at the times, you know, when she was in her pain at home, and she did yell out periodically, you know, it was sort of like, she goes, you know, I used to just be able to be so much stronger about this. It's like, hey, you know. Sometimes you just gotta say, ouch, you know, it's okay. And that's, like I say, and that's what home is. So I will, I'd like to read one little poem that she had from Hala Satavahana, which was her favorite. As you can see, she had it framed and everything. However far my eye may wander, thou standest before me. For the heavens and the splendor of the stars are thy image. And that, like I say, was one of her very favorite sayings. And oh, maybe you can actually see this too. This is a picture she had at one of the parties with her coworkers and stuff like that. And I just found this one just such a very captivating, you know, Cathy picture, as more the more mature Cathy. You had that really beautiful one that actually the friend that the longtime friend of the family that Tony talked about had taken a picture of her and her sister when they were young. And she goes, oh, you know, Sally should have been a professional photographer. And that was her picture too. But she was, like I say, always happy, always joyous. She had the insightful mind of her dad, and she had the loving spiritual of a living saint, basically like her mother, and things like that. Prayed for people every day, did even during mass, you know, when you can dedicate your host to somebody that's in pain or that's suffering, she would do that also. So always thinking of others, you know, basically just like I say, a really, really, really good friend and companion. Loved people, like I say, just loved it. And also very much for everybody's social and, you know, justice for everyone. That was her thing, you know. Things should be, you know, right. You know, well, I guess they would say in Hinduism, they would say she was a very dharmic individual. She lived her principles. And I will miss her being able to physically talk to her for the rest of my life until I get to do the big swan song into space and stuff like that. Because as I've said to friends, personally myself in the past, it's sort of like, yeah, what two choices do we have? You know, we can either go to mother's lap, we can die and go to the divine, whatever we perceive, or we get to hang out another 20 years with our friends and family. Either way, it's win-win for us, the individual. It's just the healing for those who have to stay in the limited condition of the body. Thank you so much for having this, Ava. This was wonderful. Thank you, thank you.
May God's blessing keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others and let others do for you. May you build a ladder to the stars and climb on every rung. May you stay. May you grow up to be true. May you always know the truth and see the light surrounding you. May you always be courageous, stand upright and be strong, and may you stay. Forever young. Forever young. Forever young. May you always be swift. May you have a strong foundation when the winds of change shift. May your heart always be joyful. May your song always be sung, and may you stay.
Prayer and poem for my goddess sister. Goodbye, blue house of heaven. Farewell, stars and celestial celebrities and your dramas on the screen of space. Goodbye, flowers with your traps of beauty and fragrance. You can hold me no longer, for I am flying home. Adieu to the warm embrace of Sekhmet's sunshine. Farewell, comforting breeze from the wings of butterfly maiden. Goodbye, entertaining music of Saraswati and the bright bells of pealing laughter from my sisters and brothers. I stayed long enough reveling with you all, dancing, laughing with my variously costumed thoughts in our beautiful temple, circling around our altar to goddess, a gateway to love, beauty, and community. The goddess is gazing on, oh yes, Bridget, Isis, Oshun, Kuan Yin, Hygieia, Lilith, Lakshmi, endlessly pouring her golden blessings, Kali dancing, lifting sublime feet in her deathless rhythm of timeless joy. Durga, eternally born on her great tiger, Saraswati, strumming sparkling sounds from her Veena. Eve offering her amaranthine apple of wisdom. Diana bearing her unbroken bow. Hecate holding aloft her everlasting torch, illuminating our way.
Yeah, just a minute. Just let it so they see that you're on. And you let it on so that you can check out.
And if we could have everyone please stop speaking at this moment so our recording is great. Diana bearing her unbroken bow, Hecate holding aloft her everlasting torch, illumining our way, no matter our choice of path. Great Sekhmet, holding for us forever her abiding Ankh, the continuous key of life, presiding over our perennial women's ceremonies of peace and power. Yes, I have loved you all, drinking the wine of my feelings, enjoying my passing human will with all its fun and foibles and follies. Truly, my love for you is unfading, uninterrupted. Yet now I forsake the divine intoxications of this, our Mother Earth. Goodbye, Gaia, just for now. Goodbye, muscles and bones and bodily motions. Goodbye, trusty walker. I put thee gently away from my hands, for blessedly, you are no longer needed. I thank you. Farewell, pain of my body, for I am now infinitely free. Farewell, yes, even my breath. Adieu, heart throbs, emotions, thoughts, and memories. I am flying home in the plane of peaceful silence. I go to feel my presence resting in her, my being one with her. I am goddess, my magnificence revealed to me now, and yes, yours. I am goddess, see me soar in the plane of consciousness above you. I am goddess, discover me beneath you in the sacred black earth. I am goddess, on the left of you in the rugged bark of the tree trunk. There I am. I am goddess, on the right of you in the bouquet of bright summer flowers. Inhale my bliss. I am goddess, within you, without you. I am goddess, and as one together in this moment only, for there is no other, we remember the truth that in every nook and far-flung quarter of this and every other world, in every morsel and scrap of my being, have I always been in the sacred presence of nothing but Eternal Mother, as are you. We are goddess. Blessed be. So we come to the conclusion, and there are a few minutes left of a farewell, thanking all who love Cathy. Our hearts are always together. We will always speak of her, her grace, her kindness, her wit, her wonderfulness, and she shall remain in our hearts forever and ever. And let the meeting continue for personal sharing. Those of you who wish to stay and talk with one another, see if I can figure that out. So blessed be. Thank you. Thank you all. Our hearts are together truly.
To her we shall return like a drop.